election officials making last-minute preparations for Sunday's vote, a campaign some observers have described as the dirtiest in the country's post-Soviet history. In the crosshairs of an apparent campaign of increasing government pressure is an organization called Golos, Russia's only independent election watchdog. On Saturday, its head Lilia Shibanova said she was detained at a Moscow airport for 12 hours and her laptop confiscated.
Luckily, I was able to reach my lawyer by phone. He said that any confiscation can only be carried out on the basis of a criminal investigation or by court order.
The attacks began about a week ago when the state-run newspaper Российская газета ran this article called The Voice of Money. It accused Golos of using foreign funds to discredit Russian elections. Then came this attempt by a team of reporters from the Kremlin-friendly NTV channel as they tried to enter the offices of Golos. This video was being filmed by a Golos expert while NTV reporters tried to ask questions about the group's financing. The Golos employees struck back, repeating the phrase "You are Surkov's propaganda" in a reference to Kremlin strategist Vladislav Surkov, and in an attempt to make the footage unusable. And yet on Friday, MTV showed a half-hour program attacking Golos, claiming that it was openly supporting opposition parties and was paid by foreign governments. Golos says it's being attacked for doing its job. So far, it has compiled over 5,000 complaints about violations of election law, registered on this map. Most are linked to the ruling United Russia, the party of Prime Minister Vladimir Putin. Last week, Putin warned Western governments against trying to influence the election through their funding of Russian NGOs. The pressure on Golos intensified after that speech. Roza Kazan, Al Jazeera, Moscow.